Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and in today's video we're going to be looking at the Bitcoin chart because we're forming a bull flag on the 4-hourly chart and it could cause us to break to the upside quite heavily on the daily chart. So we're going to look into that. We're going to look at the funding rates and a bunch more stuff. So make sure you stick to the end. My name is Crypto Kid and let's jump into the Bitcoin chart. So let's see. This is the daily chart for Bitcoin, and as you can see, for the past couple of weeks we were in this parallel resistance, right? And you know, we broke to the downside. However, these past couple of days we've been trending inside this resistance range between $16,725 and $17,264. And what we can see is we have this bull flag that is formed on the daily chart from the 30th of November till today. We're still in this bull flag, and it's a very nice parallel consolidation. And right now we have retested actually a couple of days back to the resistance of this bull flag, and we haven't come back down, which is good, because if you retest the resistance of any trend, of any two trend lines, it gives it more likeliness that you're going to break either up, or if it's, you know, touching the resistance line more, then you break down. Because think of resistance and support lines of thin layers of crackers, right? The more pressure it gets put on the cracker, the easier it is for it to break, right? So we can see here that the price has already touched the upper resistance once already. And if we come back and touch it again, it makes the top resistance weaker, right? So then we have a higher chance of breaking to the upside. However, again, we have to look at oscillators, right? So we have good volume today, right? We see that the MACD is coming down, right? But the MACD line and the signal line, they're coming to the upside. So this could reverse because we're still in green. If we look at our stochastic, it looks like it's going to cross to the downside. However, we see RSI trending up. So it's pretty much down to the volume if we break to the upside. And also we see some EMA resistance here as well. The EMAs are blocking us from going to the upside too. However, if we go to the 4-hourly chart, we can see this closer time frame bull flag forming for Bitcoin as well, which I'm gonna draw out right now for you guys. So here we have this bull flag forming. That's the support, and now we draw the resistance. So there we go. So this is the bull flag forming for Bitcoin, and right now we're retesting the resistance, which could cause us to break to the upside. Now, if this happens, I'm not going to count this crazy wick right there. If this happens, we could have, you know, a conservative price target of, if we were to break out right now, we could see coming back to $17,645. And what I'm going to do right now is we're going to open a trade on BitGet demo trading, which we have a $1,000 challenge. You know, it's nothing super significant, but what we're doing is, by applying proper risk management, we're seeing how we could conservatively make a lot, you know, as much profit as we can using technical analysis and risk management. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a trade if we break like here. So, you know, we could break out and that could be a fake out, right? So I'm going to do it right here just to be on the safe side. So $17,200. This is our, whoa, what just happened? Okay, I see. So if we just do a isolated, right? So we go to trigger, we want a trigger order. So at 17,200, we're going to enter at market price. And for our risk management rule, we only do 10% of our current portfolio. So if we have a look at our portfolio right now, so this takeaway to $1,000. So we started with $1,000. God, okay. So I need to do the math on this. I kind of forgot to keep track, because here you start off with $3,000. I did play around with this earlier on back in the day, so I forgot exactly where we started off. It's okay. So we'll just say we still have $1,000, because you know, we went up and down a bit. So let's do $100 here. So $110, because it has some fees, etc. And our take profit will be at $17,657. I'm just going to call it an even $17,650. Okay, so take profit will be $17,560. $650. And our stop loss is, so this is where it gets interesting, right? So here, according to our risk management rule, we cannot lose more than 20% of our trade of the trade in a single position, right? So that stops, that gives us the ability to only lose 2% of our entire portfolio, which in the grand scheme of things, it's not a huge deal, right? Because, you know, a lot of the time people just put all in into trades and lose all of their money. So that's what we're trying to prevent happening here. So if we do a conservative stop loss, right, I would put it, you know, just below this swing low, in case we break to the downside. So around $17,000, I'd put it at. And if we calculate it, so we'll calculate our leverage that we can use as well to keep in balance with our risk management. So, okay, 17,000, perfect. So it's a more than 2-to-1 ratio. We only take trades that are 2-to-1. So it's awesome. It's 1-to-3.45, which is insane. So we have so it will be 0.81%. So we can use basically 10x leverage would be 8.1%. I'm gonna use 20x leverage, so we have a 16.2% risk. So not too significant. So long here, we're gonna do 10. So we're gonna do 20x leverage. So that's awesome. Not 125, we're gonna do 20. There we go, boom. So that's perfect. So we will put our stop loss at $17,000, 1, 2, 3, and we will press buy long. And that is it, we place our order. So if Bitcoin breaks out of this mini bull flag on the 4-hourly chart, then we will set open a position. And that's awesome, it's sticking to our risk management rules. So I'm really, really happy with that. And also, if you look at the funding rates are negative. Let me refresh real quick. Yeah, it's negative. So that means that short pairs pay long positions, meaning, you know, it's according to this data, it's a good time to be longing. And if we look at the crypto bubbles, you know, I talked about this in last video, the Apple video. We talked about Toncoin as well. And I did say this coin could do insanely well. You know, on the week, we have done 10.9%. And this is actually in the video, it was at $1.84, right? And it is doing crazy because, you know, the amount of bullishness with Toncoin and, you know, the entire system that Telegram is developing is crazy. So we've actually pumped around 10% from that last video. So congratulations if you, you know, decided to do your own research and get in. Yeah, that is it for today's video. We can look at the crypto fear index as well. We're at, let me refresh, we're at 26. So it's a nice time to be DCAing. But again, nothing in this video is financial advice. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Take care. Leave a like if you like the video as always, and subscribe if you haven't already. Take care, guys, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.